everyone, it's Inky Finger Cat.
I've got some new stuff. So I have some more of the Paperartsy fresco finish paints, the chalk acrylics. I've got the second Seth Apter limited edition set, which has got key lime, which is a semi-opaque, mud splat, which is an opaque, green patina, love this colour, semi-opaque, and smoked paprika, which is a translucent. And I got the Tracy Scott ones as well, so the Tracy Scott limited editions. So you've got two opaques, the jade and the butternut, a semi-opaque, which is the prawn, which is a really pretty pink colour, and tangerine twist, which is a translucent. And I actually think that they'll all go really well together, but my intention is to make one card with that one and one card with that one. So I thought I would put the video on and you could watch me play. So as you can see, they're all brand new, still in the packaging. I'm just gonna start playing. Ooh, I just have to decide which one I want to play with first.
Thank you.
Right, so that's card number one. So that one's for Matthew. Bit grungy, bit army-like, those colours, really. Bit camouflage-like. I've got the Kim Dello stamp and the text stamp, which, because it's quite a scribbly text, it doesn't matter that it's the wrong way up, because that would normally bother me, but actually you can't really tell that it's meant to be text, so really happy with that. And then I just took a stamp from a magazine set with the kite, and then stamped out in alphas Matthew's name. The happy birthday is a woodware stamp that I've heat embossed. And then just to differentiate a little bit, I've coloured in the happy birthday using a white spectrum noir pencil, and it just adds that little bit of something different to it. And then just edged it with some, let me just find it, the sepia ink, the archival sepia ink, in order to frame it. And then the blank card blank, I think that does perfectly. I'm pretty confident that Matthew will like his card. So there's the boy one done, now to the girl one. Right, so there's my girl card made. So I actually grabbed the same set of stamps that I used for Matthew's card to do this cute balloon image for Hannah's, but obviously using a different colour scheme, but keeping it all to the same idea, the embossing, the painted backgrounds, some random stamping in the background just to add some pattern. On this one I did it with my paintbrushes, so you've got brush marks in this, which is a bit different. I also added some spatters, which I didn't do to Matthew's card. Again, I painted the piece that was used for the name before I embossed that and added the sentiment. So I'm really happy with that. This one I edged with the watering can archival. So, two completely different cards, both created with the fresco finish paints. This one with the Tracy Scott set, which is the prawn, the jade, the tangerine twist, and the butternut. I can see myself using those colours a lot. For Matthew's, I used the key lime green patina, which I adore. It's like it is like the patina that you get to copper when it's oxidised. The smoked paprika and the mud splat. Now, that one I can't imagine using very much. But, you know what? Who knows? So, there you go. Two cards. Done and dusted. Two 11-year-olds. Quite graffiti and grungy looking, but I think they'll both like them. And both very different. One boy, one girl. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, please do give me a thumbs up, and obviously subscribe if you want to see more. Thanks very much. Bye.